अरे यार स्थिति गड़बड़ हो गई। 1 मिनट। ओके, होप यू आर वी आर ऑन स्लाइड नंबर 8। सो वी हैव जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूटेड रूल नंबर 2 एंड 1 एंड 2 इनटू रूल नंबर 4। सो वी गॉट दिस न्यू प्रोडक्शन ऑफ ए। सो ए इज जनरेटिंग कैपिटल ए एडी एंड ए इज जनरेटिंग लोअर केस बीडी। सो इन दिस वे we can substitute this new substitution into the original grammar. So we get like this. So A to C, A, AD, BD and epsilon. Epsilon is already there in the original grammar. So in this way, we have done this. Now, I think there is some problem. In this way, this is 9th slide. And here we are using straight rule to remove the left recursion. For example, if you go for a production, so there are two production rules, AC and AAD. They are calling itself. This is a left recursion. So we are not using here our simple left recursion removal rule. We are going to use here straight rule. So I have already given this straight rule. We have seen here. So here what we have to do? We have to just think in terms of pattern matching. We have to just match this pattern, blue color production rules with the straight rule. So what straight rule says? So whatever alphas are there, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to m, and whatever betas are there up to 1 to n. So we have to identify alphas and betas. So here, two production rules are there, which are calling itself. So we need alpha 1 and alpha 2. And again, we need to identify beta 1 and beta 2 in the A production rule, because A is a left recursive production rule. So for example, here you can visualize that C is matching to alpha 1. Lowercase ad is matching to alpha 2. Right? I hope you are getting it. Then beta 1 can be bd and beta 2 can be epsilon. Just it is a simple plain pattern matching with the straight rule. So don't get confused. So once we have alpha 1 and alpha 2, beta 1 and beta 2, we can just write the new production rules like A is A, beta 1, A dash, then beta 2, A dash. Now here beta 2 is a epsilon. So you are directly writing A dash. Now we have to generate A dash production rules. So as per the pattern, so alpha 1 is C. So C, A dash. Alpha 2 is AD, so AD, A dash, and slash epsilon. So in this way, we have converted a production rule by using a straight rule into the RR, that is a right recursive production. So here it is a right recursive, means on the right side, on the non-terminal is there. So we can collect all this and we get new set up the production rules. Here totally 7 production rules are there in new production, new grammar. So this is equivalent to the original grammar G1. So I suggest, even though those who think that there is some they should work out on do it on a paper and pen and paper, so they will understand this is not hard. But here, What is problem? Here you see the A production. A is calling to A dash. This is called as a unit production. So unit productions are not desirable. In this example, we are not learning how to remove the unit productions. So we shall see in some other example. But for the but this solution is sufficient, and we have removed all the left recursion as well as cycles from the original given grammar. So anyway, we are now switching to the new algorithm that is called the left factoring of a grammar. Now, what is left factoring? So there might be some production rules in a given grammar that which starts with same symbol, which has same prefix. For example, alpha is a prefix. See, don't think that, don't try to interpret right now this algorithm. We are working out on one or two examples, then you will easily understand what is this algorithm says. So here input is a given grammar, output is that left factor grammar. And why we are using is, we want to remove common prefixes from a production rules on the right hand side of a grammar. So I will tell you what is a prefix. So here alpha is a prefix and gamma is not a prefix. So if such production rule is there, we are converting like this. So here again, in left factoring, we are substituting new non-terminal, say A dash. And we have to run this algorithm repeatedly on some given example. So this is a recursive algorithm. So it is given on page number 214. You can download this PDF of this book. So left factoring is a grammar transformation that is useful for producing a grammar suitable for a predictive or top-down parsing. So you got this. That what is the importance of left factoring? Predictive parsers and top-down parsing parsers. So that is the importance. So left-factored grammars are required in a predictive and top-down parsers. So actually, predictive parser itself is a top-down parser. That is not a problem. Anyway, are you with me? I think you are listening to me. Anyway, so here one sample is given, that let us say is a production on the left hand side, which starts with, so two alternatives are there. Both alternatives starts with alpha. So alpha is a prefix. So it is a string of terminals or string of non-terminals, or it may be combination of terminals as well as non-terminals. So if you have such situation, if you have a common prefix on the right hand side of a production rule, then you can directly convert this into this. Means you are writing like this, A giving alpha A dash, alpha A dash is a new production non-terminal, and A dash is equal to beta 1 and beta 2. So this is a way. And alpha is a common prefix. So we want to remove all the production rules which starts with same symbol. Please note what I'm saying. We don't need the production rules which starts with same symbol. Just imagine the expression grammar. So here, see example number 4.22. So here, S has three production rules, like I, E, T, S, right? So production rule number one and two starts with same symbol, right? And this is not advisable for predictive parsers. So we shall see what is E. E means expression, S means statement, I means if, T means then, if then else. And A is a terminal and B is a terminal. Let us say here only two non-terminals are there, two capital letters are there, and total four production rules are there. So you can read from the book. So this is called the dangling else problem. We shall see what is the dangling else problem. So above part is giving you the simple rule of the left factoring. Here, assume that alpha is not equal to empty, or alpha should not be empty. That is a condition. But there can be generalized rule like this. There are n number of production rules which starts with same prefix, and they are directly converted into by generalized rule like this. A, alpha, A dash, then gamma. This is a gamma symbol. Write down this in your copy, or you may take screenshot. Or and A dash is giving you beta 1, beta 2, up to beta n. These are the again the strings, you know, given production rule. So note this, we shall see in a next example. Now just think that this is a new example. We are doing left factoring on this grammar. So here, as I told you, capital E stands for expression. So expression is nothing but it is an expression grammar. Just recall the previous grammar. We have learned that S is something called as a statement, programming language statement or instruction. Lowercase I means if, lowercase T means then, lowercase E means else, if then else. And A is simply some terminal. Now we want to left factor it. So for that, we have to identify alpha. Alpha is a prefix. So what could be the prefix in this given grammar? Just think. So here I have colored red. I, capital E, lowercase t, and capital S. So these are the common characters in two production rules. Right? And on the left side, I have given you the rule. This is called as the left factoring rule. So just you have to do the pattern matching. Please note, it is not hard. So here what we have to do, you have to identify alpha, then beta 1 and beta 2 from the given grammar. I think today I am facing some problems. I don't know what is happening to your end, but you can send me screenshots or some whatever problem you are facing, and you can send me on my personal WhatsApp. So we need to identify alpha and beta 1 and beta 2. So here red letter prefix is there. We can call it as alpha. Then just match this with the rule. Now here beta 1 can be epsilon. See, just you have to visualize this. Don't ye zor zabardasti se nahi karna padega. You have to visualize this. K by beta 1 can be epsilon and beta 2 can be lowercase e and capital S. and your gamma will be lowercase a. So if you are able to match pattern comfortably with the given rule, then you will face no difficulty. So once we have alpha, beta 1 and beta 2, we can directly rewrite the given grammar like this. So I have written it in blue color. So S is given to I, E, T, S, S dash. And A, S dash is giving you epsilon, because beta 1 is epsilon and beta 2 is lowercase es. And again, E to B is a given rule. So in this way, we can solve. We can do left factoring. Now see, observe the given grammar. It is in red color, black color. And observe the blue color transform grammar. So here, what is happening? All productions, all right-hand side productions starts with different symbol. And second thing is that all production rules starts with lowercase letter. This is required in the design of the parsing. So every production rule on the right-hand side is starting with the lowercase letter, that is terminal. This is required. And this is called as a look-ahead symbol. See here, S contains one look-ahead symbol. That is a terminal. H dash contains only one lowercase letter, that is terminal. That's why this is a, there is a one look ahead. So is in this way, one look ahead, two look ahead, K look ahead can be there. So I hope this got, you got this. Oh, I just want to, there might be some students, but I don't know. I don't know how many of you have visited this site, but I suggest you to use the Mozilla Firefox and use this IP address and go to the particular directory in public b_cac3rss and then ss lab programs. You will get some set of programs. Just go to download on your machine, try to run on your site. Then lot many material is available on this site, including PPTs, video lectures, some PDFs are there, some books are there, some tips are there. So I suggest and try to understand, learn how to use WinSCP and PuTTY. Right now, I'm not going to tell you what to do with this, but as a third year student, you should be familiar what is a WinSCP and PuTTY, what to do with them. So actually PuTTY is used to remotely log into remote system. WinSCP is to copy some files from remote system. It may be Windows, Linux, or Android, or any OS. So these tools are there. Just try to get familiar with them. Now let us go to the third example. I hope you are able to, because today we have faced two or three obstacles. I don't know. But anyway, this is the third grammar. We need to left factor. Why? Just by observing the given grammar, you can easily guess. See, all production rules are starting with same symbol, lowercase a, right? So this is called as a prefix. And when parser is parsing something in doing some derivation, so parser cannot decide which production rule it should choose to do the derivation or parsing, because all production rule starts with same prefix. And that's why it is not advisable in any compiler. So we need to do the left factoring. So this is a straight rule. We are not using here simple rule. We are using here straight rule. Here on left side, alpha, beta 1, alpha, beta 2, like this until gamma is there. We are converting into A, alpha, A dash, gamma, and A dash, beta 1, beta 2, up to beta n, like this. This is called as a generalized rule. So you have to just do the pattern matching with the given grammar. So you have to identify what is alpha, beta 1 and beta 2 here. And you have to understand what is gamma. Now, there is nothing gamma. So you can assume epsilon. So you have to wisely assume. You cannot assume anything, but you have to wisely assume in order to match with the rule. So here what? I am supposing that alpha is lowercase a. I am writing it in red letter. And beta 1 is ab. Beta 2 is a capital B and lowercase c. And beta 3 is a capital A and lowercase c. And gamma is epsilon. Just imagine it is epsilon. It should be consistent. आपका substitution ऐसा होना चाहिए कि original grammar का जो meaning है उसको उसने change नहीं करना चाहिए. It should keep the original meaning of the grammar. That's it should generate the new grammar which should be equivalent to original grammar. So you have to substitute wisely. So let us say this is step one. So by using this generalized rule, we can directly write the productions. A is giving to small a, a dash. And a dash is beta 1, beta 2, and beta 3. Right? Now here, we are not writing gamma because gamma is empty. I hope you got this. So this is step one. Please note that don't confuse with the left recursion and left factoring. Here we are only doing the left factoring of a grammar. Now, we have generated A dash in a blue color. Now what is happening here? There are two production rules on the right hand, which starts with capital A, right? And one production rule starts with capital B. So you can rearrange the production rules. So all production rules which starts with capital A, ek side mein rakh do, aur jo remaining, dusre side mein rakh do, like this. AB, AC and BC. I have just rearranged them. Now actually this is a case of left recursion, right? But we are not solving the left recursion problem. Here we are solving the problem of left factoring. So again, we have to find alpha. These are the A dash is there, right? And we are using new non-terminal A double dash. So in this case, alpha can be capital A. This is a common prefix into two productions. Beta 1 can be capital B. Beta 2 can be lowercase c. And gamma can be capital B and c. This is simple. You just think in terms of the prefixes. So we have A, we have A dash. Now from A dash, we are generating new non-terminal A double dash. So just by doing the pattern matching, A dash is giving you A. Actually, it should be A dash, A double dash. So alpha A dash. Means, and then gamma is there, that is a BC. And this new non-terminal A double dash is giving you beta 1 and beta 2. Beta 1 is capital B, beta 2 is lowercase c. So we have generated new non-terminals A dash and A double dash. Means we are doing this recursively. So in this way, in blue color, we got new set of production rules. Original grammar contains three production rules. New transform grammar contains six production rules. So I hope if you repeat this example with pen and paper, you will understand it easily. So until and unless you repeat, do on a pen and paper, so things will not be simple. So I hope we have covered this third example. Now, This is a homework question slide. So what I suggest is that you go through the books, or you may go through the Google and try to understand, because we are learning here syntax analysis or parsing. So try to identify how error occurs, how syntax error occurs. So this is a very hard question, and try to write one or two paragraph answer of this question. I will be definitely discussing with you how error occurs. See, in previous slides we have seen that there are error detection as well as correction methods. But this is the conceptual question. We are not thinking about how to detect the error and how to remove the error. We are not thinking. We are thinking how error occurs, how syntax error occurs. So just prepare one paragraph or two paragraphs with some suitable example, and you can send me on WhatsApp or even on email. Then second question is there, that is important. So you have to understand what is unit production and what is the disadvantage of unit production in a grammar. If a grammar contains a unit production, means a capital letter is calling another capital letter. Non-terminal is calling to another non-terminal letter. And so you have to think that how to remove the unit productions. And you have to answer this question with suitable example, that how unit production is removed from the given grammar. Definitely I will be giving you one example, but due to this PPTs, it is sometimes hard to understand. But if you do the paperwork, you can easily understand how to remove the unit production. But what is the disadvantage of unit production? You have to identify. So I suggest you Google it, or you may go through the book, standard book, you will get the answer. Now, third question is, what is the purpose of late factoring? So as I told you that in this unit, we are working on top-down parsers. We are typically learning about the predictive parsers. So what is prediction? So during the derivation, when you consume the tokens or string of tokens during the parsing, so depending on the start of the production rule, starting letter of the production rule, you can decide, you can predict. See, if you we can go here back. Let us take this example. It is on slide number 13. See here, three non-terminals are there, and all production rules are there, which starts with different letter. For example, yes has two production rules, which starts with capital A and B. A has two production rules, which starts with lowercase b and capital A dash. In the similar way, A dash is there, which starts with C, A, and epsilon. Means what is happening? All production rules on the right hand side starts with different letter. So this gives us the power to the prediction. So we don't get confused when we do the derivation. Ki konsa production rule lena chahiye. For example, we have seen previously E giving you E plus E, E star E, like that, and in bracket E. So what is happening? All production rules are starting with same symbol, same letter. So there might be chances of backtracking. In backtracking, there might be chances of wrong choosing of a production rule during the derivation. So derivation process may stop somewhere. So in such situation where there are all production rules which starts with all different letters, terminals or capital letters, whatever, means these are the different alternatives. All alternatives are different. So it gives us prediction power. We can do prediction in proper way, right? So this is something more, question number three, that what is the purpose of left factoring? Because we want to avoid common prefixes from a given grammar, because we want to design a predictive parser. In predictive parser, a grammar should not have same starting letters. All production rules have different starting letters or characters. And this simplifies the parsing process, because we have separate alternatives. Now, there is a question number four, that why a top-down parser cannot handle left recursion. I already given you general hint that if there is a recursion, that to the left recursion. See, right recursion is also dangerous. It doesn't mean that left recursion is dangerous and right recursion is not dangerous. In some situations, right recursion is also dangerous. Here, what is happening? During the left recursion or elimination of left recursion, what we are doing? We are converting left recursive production rules into right recursive production rules. But it doesn't mean that right recursive production rules are also advantageous. It is not so. But in case of the top-down parsers, left recursion is not suitable. We shall see what is the use of the right recursion while learning the bottom-up parsing. Now again, you have to keep in mind that in top-down parsing, which starts when we do the parsing, means derivation. Actually, parsing is nothing but derivation. We start with the start symbol. For example, yes, and then we go on substituting the non-terminals until we generate the given string of tokens, right? This is the way how we do top-down parsing. But in case of the bottom-up parsing, what we do? We directly start with the given string. Whatever string is there, whatever statement is there, we start with that, and then we do reverse derivation, means we reduce the string by substituting the left-hand side of the production rule. So, and from given statement, we start reducing it to start symbol in the down. So top-down and bottom-up are totally different methods. So in next session, we are going to understand what are different types of top-down parsers. So for example, there is a recursive descent parser. Then another is a predictive parser. So we are trying to learn how to generate the parsing table for a predictive parser. Now for a recursive descent parser, we don't need a parsing table. See, there are some parsers which require parsing table. Please note this thing in your copy. And there are some parsers which don't need parsing table. So recursive descent parser is an example where we don't need parsing table. But rest of the parsers like LL parser, predictive parsers, LR parser, SLR parser, LALR parser, all these parsers need parsing table. Means we have to design a parsing table. And how do we design it? We design it from given grammar. So for example, how to design a predictive parser? So for that, we have to learn two algorithms. One is called as a first set, another is called as a follow set. So once we generate a first set and follow set, actually it's a set. And there is a table generation algorithm. So by using these two sets, we can generate the table. So I will be showing you in next session how to build the predictive parser or how to build the predictive parsing table by computing first and follow set. So I request you to visit at least last 3-4 lecture slides. So get crystal clear idea that what is a left recursion, why we are going to remove it from a grammar. Then try to understand what is the danger of the left recursive production rule. Then clearly understand what is a left factoring, why it is needed. So you just scan previous slides and then we shall begin with how to build a parsing table with some examples. So I suggest please send me some screenshots, because today we got 2-3 interruptions. I don't know what happened, but we got 2-3 interruptions. So I request you to go through the at least last 3-4 lectures. You can download from FTP as well as from MS Teams resources. And once you have refresh previous sessions, then it will be very easy, because to generate a parsing table is a normally very big computation. A lot many things are there. So sometimes it may happen that a single slide is insufficient to show the parsing table and the processing. So we have to learn how to build a parsing table. We have to learn how to generate the first and follow set from the given grammar. Then we have to generate how to process a given string by using the parsing table. See, right now, up till now, you only understand how to do the derivation, leftmost derivation and rightmost derivation. That is there. But you are not understanding now how to do parsing by using parsing table. So actually, doing parsing by using parsing table is nothing but it is a visualization of doing the leftmost or rightmost derivation, whatever we have done previously. And you must have that idea, okay, what happens in leftmost derivation, what happens in rightmost derivation. So I think I must stop here. Please send me your comments. If you have some doubt, you can send me on the personal WhatsApp. So I'm ending here. I hope you have received me clearly. Today I just covered the left factoring and one example of the straight rule of the left recursion. There are a lot many examples, but if you repeat whatever I have given the examples, whatever we are learning in this class, that these examples are sufficient. You don't need to work out on many more examples. And whatever grammars I have given here in these examples in previous lectures, same examples are asked in exam, university exam. So I suggest you work out with pen and paper on your side, so that you will get comfort, some crystal clear idea. So I am stopping here. I am thankful to you. Nobody has disturbed me, and you have listened to me very patiently. So thank you very much.